Hey guys, Alton Elizabeth, Quarantine Kitchen. We're kind of bickering a little bit about what we want to cook tonight because neither of us have had any time to do any thinking about anything.
We're like so super shadowy dark, aren't we?
Well, it's moody. It's like film noir.
Okay.
It looks it's hip. Kids like that.
Kids okay.
So we need to. Come here. So we're having a discussion about, we have a lot of leftovers. And we've got like some chicken and some asparagus and some fish. And at least one night a week really should kind of be about, I think,
Eating.
Clearing the decks and eating.
For sure. You had fun grilling this weekend. So we have all kinds of really wonderful. We have fish and chicken.
We do. We have fish because for those of you that watch our app thing on Food Network, I had to make another fish because I forgot to take pictures of the first fish. So we had another fish. And then I spoke to chicken over the weekend. And then we have some asparagus. So we're looking around the pantry. Now we've gone out. We've snuck out and gone to the grocery, but not the big grocery store, only a little kind of bodega kind of health thing.
Yes.
Because we're still scared to go to the market because we've seen some shit, you know, and Georgia's numbers are, I mean, you can all you want, but truth is the truth. So looking around, my pet.
Well, we've talked about doing.
We have.
Tortillas, because of the gluten-free thing, I have to do corn. I'm going to do masa. I did get some masa.
So what you want to do is you want to make leftover
tacos.
Okay, we have that kind of time. The only thing that we actually prepared was a cocktail. So we'll at least move on to the cocktail, and then we'll deal with making some masa dough. She's right, gluten-free. This is really just corn. It even says gluten-free right there. So just to make sure, so we're definitely gonna we'll cook tortillas, actual tortillas? Okay.
Yeah.
Then I'm gonna make sure that the griddle is set to medium-high,
which corn, is typically. And you said you've been talking about elote.
We can make elote.
Yeah.
Let's make a drink and then we do. You're absolutely right. So we could do an elote thing, which is my very, very favorite thing to do. This night's
I was kind.
Look, flower arrangement.
I left a hole for his head.
She did make it where I could actually sneak in and grab a knife if I'm really, really, really careful. But speaking of knives. Well, speaking of knives, I'm going to be moving a little slowly tonight. Okay. I had a touch of the skin cancer, probably from wagging this arm out car windows for 50 plus years without sunscreen. So I've got stitches.
Let's be specific. It was squamous cell, right?
What?
Not melanoma.
It's not. It's basal cell, which mostly is what old people get. But still, not good, and it hurts. I got a bunch of stitches, and so that's happened. So I need a drink, and I'm going to, by golly, have one. But you're going to have to do a lot of the work tonight. Not that you don't usually. You usually do a good bit of the work anyway. So good evening to all of you. Thank you for joining us. It's been another crazy-ass week.
Especially here in Georgia.
Shit cray in Georgia.
We just can't seem to stay out of the news. We're doing really fabulous.
We'd kind of like to. We'd like to. So we're going to make a cocktail.
Just for a week. I do want to say there's some certain public figures in this city that have really become heroes of mine. And I think a lot of people, so.
Okay, I'm going to get that.
There is some pride. There's actually quite a bit of pride.
And it's Pride Month.
And it's Pride Month.
It's Pride Month.
Yeah.
And some good news out of the
Supreme Court.
You know, okay.
There's been stuff happening. All right.
This is a cocktail we've not made before, and you'll notice that we've got some gin here. I'm hoping that's 4 ounces because that's what we're going to need. People at Beefeater.
What?
Well, they could send us some.
Oh.
We're also going to be using two different kinds of vermouth. We're going to be using a Rosso, a red vermouth, and an extra dry vermouth. We are not endorsing Dolan. It's just the brand that they had. Please keep in mind that once vermouth is open, it is a fortified wine. It needs to be refrigerated. Keep this stuff refrigerated or it will go bad very, very, very quickly. All right, I just want to mention that. So this is a cocktail called the Bronx.
Bronx.
I gotta say back. It was invented in 1906 at the Waldorf Astoria Hotel, and it was in honor of the opening of the Bronx Zoo, which apparently opened in 1906.
Hey, does anyone know how the COVID tigers and lions are doing? Because that was Bronx Zoo also.
Was that the Bronx Zoo?
Mm-hmm.
Well, then we should drink to their health.
We're
going to drink
to
their health. So, and this also involves some orange juice. And you'll notice we have a stunning set of old Eastern Airlines first class stemware. It's about as close to an airplane as I'm going to be getting anytime soon, I can tell you that. I'm going to grab the...
Do we need ice?
I hope the jigger's already over there because everybody knows how I like to...
Yes, you have.
Then we're fighting the whole thing if I'm too tall for the bar. We can't.
Oh, look, now I guess
we can't see.
It's for myself.
We can't see things, so yeah. You're not going to see out the bottom
it's
of the frame.
It's for my pretty
so.
Tray, which our friend.
Well, we can't because it's. Well, I guess us. I could. Yeah, our friend Janice gave us this awesome tray. We'll show it off after I use all this stuff.
Okay.
So this is going to be 2 ounces of gin. Here, could you?
No, you're not handing me the camera.
Okay, I'm not going to hand you the camera. Okay. I
did my time last week.
You did.
And you guys were wonderful and very patient, and it was fun.
They're just not going to see everything. So we're going to have 2 of these because we both need a drink. She drove me to the doctor. She was very, very concerned. She came back to pick me up. I could smell strange cologne in the car, but we'll talk about that another time. It's the same cologne that the pool boy wears.
We don't have a pool.
We don't even have a pool. I just always wanted to say
there
that.
There is no
and,
pool boy.
And why is the pool boy here on Tuesday? We don't have a pool. I would
if
love
the pool,
pool
boy starts showing up, that would
there's
be
a problem.
Suspicious.
So we're gonna need 4 ounces of the dry
is
lemon
gin. 4 ounces per beverage?
No, that's total.
I'm just.
Oh,
I mean,
we should probably put some ice in here.
Why was?
No, don't pour out. No, you know what?
Out.
No,
I'm
no, wait, 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 wait,
top.
Wait. Let's we'll do this new style. I'm making this up. My head's being chopped off. Oh, we're barely going to make it. This
kids.
Is going to be for the kids. You know, for the kids.
The kids.
Beef eater. What the hell? All right, I'll get ice. Don't worry, Scabs. Don't get up. Scabs is in her corner.
Going to get ice. Don't
Scabs
hurt yourself.
Scabs is in her corner. Don't hurt me.
Well, you don't. He's been very ginger with the arm. He should. It's like... I guess the skin cancer
I'm not gonna lie.
Sneaks up on you.
It hurts.
Yeah, well, you had
My skin cancer hurts.
A hunk cut out.
I did. I had a hunk about the size of a nice piece of spam. I should have asked for it.
No!
Little Hannibal.
God, anybody watch the app last night with him eating the marrow?
All right, where's the... I'll use this cocktail spoon because it's what I can find. We also need half an ounce... of each of the 2 vermouths. So that's gonna be, since we're having 2 drinks, I'm actually gonna fill this whole thing. There we go.
Yeah.
It's been that kind of day.
Bigger.
I need my medicine. We're gonna need a bigger mixer glass.
We
are. Okay, so that's gonna be a full ounce of that. And then 2, we are. I should have made these 1 at a time.
You need like a witch's vat.
I do. And then, 2 ounces of the juice total, 1 ounce per. Woo! That's right to the edge there.
Perfect. Wait, not long
enough. Will you start my sweet? People are saying, okay, please don't mix painkillers and alcohol. I don't have any painkillers.
That's the problem.
Nobody gave me any of the painkillers. So I don't have any painkillers. So the only thing I'm mixing this with is a bad frickin' attitude. Okay? That's all I'm doing. Did you get that? Oh, that looks pretty mixed. Oh.
I would not let him eat painkillers. And
she wouldn't let me eat painkillers.
I wouldn't
killers.
Do it.
Okay, I can't stand this anymore. Hold on. We're gonna go back to the Dutch angle so that I don't chop the top of my... Well, there's your plant. There we go.
There it is.
All right, now we strain.
Oak leaf hydrangeas. Foraged.
Stolen.
No, well, stolen from ourselves.
Well, it's still kind of stolen when you think about it. Mm. I'm not going to garnish this. You know why? Because I didn't prepare to garnish.
What would be the
Tuesday
garnish?
Freaking night. Who needs a damn garnish? What I should have done is not spill the drink. No, this one's yours. Yours is the one that's nicer.
I'm just moving it for you.
Oh, well, move Thank it into you. My mouth. Okay. So, the Bronx, gin.
The Bronx.
2 different vermouths. Rosso and extra dry and orange juice.
Very nice. I like it.
That doesn't even taste like it has alcohol in it. I'll have 4. By the end of the night, I'd be like, this is fine. This doesn't
maybe take it off.
I get up in the morning and there'd be blood all over the place. That is, that's lovely. That's we should write that down.
Why do we not all know this drink?
It's just not a very, I think it's because most people in America still aren't hip fully to vermouth. And so I think that they'll buy a dry vermouth. Well, that's not true because, of course, you need a Rosso sweet vermouth for Negronis and Boulevardiers, which are the only thing still holding our society together at this point. Don't you think? Well, maybe not. I'm not doing it.
Really well, we went to a wonderful restaurant. Well, here, it was a while ago, but Adar.
We went to a restaurant?
I
don't remember. Tell me, what is this?
Months ago.
What is this restaurant?
Yeah.
It's like, did you see that metal thing in the sky today that looked like a bird, but it made noise and it didn't flap its wings? Scared the hell out of me.
Yeah.
Okay, so Eight Arm.
But it was like a vermouth flight, and it was wonderful.
Vermouth is a wonderful thing.
It is a wonderful thing.
Americans need to get hip to them.
Yeah.
You're in the plant. You want to be in the plant. You're mysterious. I want to compliment my wife's sartorial taste tonight with this handsome, fetching, Mandarin style shirt.
I had it done made in. Hong Kong.
There's a little edge of Kate Capshaw, Indiana Jones, Temple of Doom going on there.
But it's in a men's...
But it's like men's...
It's in a men's fabric.
A suit fabric. Very nice.
Yeah. Matt, if you're watching, I want 5 more. Matt was not in Hong Kong, but...
Matt wasn't in Hong Kong. Long story. We'll tell it some other time. All right. Let's get to cooking. Unless you guys want to ask a question while we just... I tell you what, we'll just drink our drink and we'll bring this thing close for some intimacy so that we can see the questions. It will take a couple of minutes just to read questions. I mix sweet vermouth with sherry and orange peel. I like that. Oh, wait. What is your lovely black countertop? This is the same stuff. Well, you tell them, Elizabeth. This is.
It's actually a black granite, but it's basically the same stuff. Or Corian also makes.
It's
chemistry, like a chemistry.
It's from lab. It's what you had in biolab.
Lab stuff.
It's lab counter. And what's really cool about it is that it has spots that are ferrous enough to where magnets will stick to it. I had a magnet in here. I was working on a Goodies thing once. It was a round magnet, and it scared the hell out of me at night. I put the thing down, and it rolled halfway down the counter and stopped. It was like, time to move out. Time to go to the robot. It's lab. It's
very
lab
durable.
Counter. Heat, it can take, you could drop molten lava on there, and it wouldn't care. So. Yeah. And it's not very expensive. It's just like, because they make it for labs. You could probably even find some old school someplace, go in at night with a crowbar and just jack that stuff
but
up off the counters.
You're not promoting that idea.
No. You wouldn't do that.
Okay.
Especially if the little Bunsen burner things were still hooked up to the gas line, because then you could cause an explosion and you wouldn't want to do that either. So. There you go.
Next question.
Bourbon recommendations. We're not drinking that tonight. You love that idea. Come over here. Drink. We never do this. We never just sit and have a cocktail and look. Favorite ways to eat potatoes. Let's say I answer that one. And that's from Lethia. What's your favorite
random.
Way?
Why potatoes on the brain?
I don't know. She's what she's thinking about. Maybe she's going to make potatoes tonight.
Okay.
There is nothing better than
potato chips.
The French fries.
And French fries. Pommes frites.
Pommes frites.
Amsterdam, that place we went.
We went to a place in Amsterdam. The last time we traveled overseas, we went to Amsterdam before Christmas. Only for 5 days.
Four days, yeah.
Man, do they know their frites. In Belgium, you know, they say they cook them in horse fat.
They do.
Yeah, I know they do. Where's the red thing over the range hood?
Oh, we had to.
Well,
it's
interesting because I did a shoot. For Food Network here today for a show called Best Thing I Ever Made. And they didn't like it. They were like, that needs to come down. Dutch potatoes, those are excellent. The red pig, do you want the red pig? Fine, I'm gonna go find the red pig. The red pig's
That's here. How you know you're watching us and not someone else, says the red pig. Hi, Narek. Cutthroat coming back, that's not the soup cans. Also the soup cans had to be removed because copyright laws, that was for the same shoot.
So this is the
look at his little teeth. You've never seen the face. He's very fierce. Look how fierce he is.
I think that's baby bok choy.
Yes, you said it was kale the other day, but it's actually bok choy.
Oh wait, no, it isn't. It's parsley. No, it isn't because it's.
It's something Chinese that
it's
we
like
don't
Chinese
even know.
Celery
the name
or
of.
Something. Anyway, his little
look
ears.
Look at his face. Wait, he's got a little face. We should name him. Okay.
Oinkers.
We want a suggestion as to what to name him. Please name our pig.
Our red Chinese pig.
Name
and
our
I still
pig
don't understand why this exists. It's got something to do with a Chinese New Year.
What will we send the person that names the pig? Not the pig.
Why not? You know what we'll do? No. We'll cut an ear off the pig and send
that. Oh, you get a pig ear.
So we will, for whoever
Char-Soo.
Wins, and name, well, Oinkers. How are we going to even know? So look, here's the thing.
Mm.
We can go through them later.
I'll go through.
Send in your best request.
Char-Soo.
Your best
why
idea.
Char-Soo? What does that mean?
Because
Char-Soo-y.
It's a Char-Soo's a dish.
Char-Soo-y.
It's a street.
Oh, sweet pig.
It's a street skewer.
But I get meat. It. Char-Soo-y.
If you'd read my last cookbook, there's a Char-Soo-y recipe in it. So if you win,
Wilbur.
We'll do this. We'll find a way to contact you, and we'll send you this pig ear, which you will prize. Probably for the rest of
okay,
your
life. Okay, you know what we're going to do?
This
we're going to pick the top 10.
This looks very blank now.
Right, I know. The people are just asking where are the soup cans. And I was
do you want me to go put
something.
The soup cans back?
No. No. We're good. We're zen. We're feeling I'm very... Gonna... You know what the black is for? The black is for things happening.
Which
black lives matter, for real.
What's the black that's happening here?
What's happening?
No, the black here. That's, I mean, like...
No,
room.
We're in solidarity...
Oh,
whatever.
I missed the reference. I'm sorry. I thought you were talking about the black of the walls or something. I didn't understand. I was over there.
We're stripped down. It's like when you hang black over the portraits, like when they hang black over the portraits.
But that's at a funeral, isn't it? Is that when somebody dies? I'm just saying traditionally, and yes, I'm not having a political conversation. I'm mm-hmm. saying, isn't that a thing like
yes.
in the South where
mm-hmm.
you hang?
It is exactly that.
All right. Paprika the pig. Pig named Grits. I kind of like Grits.
Come on, Grits.
Call him
Dinner.
J-Pig. Shiva.
Pulpy.
Jew. The pig should be called Jew.
Okay.
Sasha's
so we're
very clear on that.
We're going to.
Kushan.
We're going to pick the top 10, and then we're going to put it out to you guys
Haggis.
On Twitter. On Twitter. Orwell.
You want to do it on Twitter?
I like Orwell.
Orwell. Animal Farm.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. I we're like going that. To Piggy.
No, we're not going to name it Piggy, though. That
no, but that's
really
what it was. Anyway.
Definitely not Orwell. This is gonna be.
We're gonna
water.
Top 10, and then we're gonna, and then we'll choose, and then we'll put it out to you guys to vote on Twitter.
And you know what I'm gonna do? I will make a video that will be a takeoff on the infamous scene from Reservoir Dogs.
Oh.
Of cutting the pig's ear off with a razor. I will totally Michael Madsen that thing. That'd be great. I'll put on Stuck in the Middle with You.
Was he Mr. Pink? What was
you know,
his name?
And I'll, oh, hell. All right. Come on, guys. Michael
Madsen.
Which color was
Reservoir
he
Dogs.
In Reservoir Dogs? Was he Mr. White?
Was he pink?
No, it wasn't Mr. Pink. That was... Wasn't Tim Roth Mr. Pink?
Yes, he was. You're right. What was Michael Madsen's
somebody
guy.
Color? Mr. Blonde.
Blonde.
Mr. Blue. No, we have a disagreement. Blonde, Mr. Blonde. Okay, everybody's got Mr. Blonde.
He was
so
blonde.
Whoever wins, we will do a video. We'll put on Stuck in the Middle with You, and I'll get a razor, and is that burn?
He's saying blue
stink?
Now. Okay,
Mr.
you guys,
White, Mr.
fight
Blonde.
It
there's
out.
So many people that don't know.
Fight it out.
I need, how could I not know this?
Me either. It's been
I'm kind of embarrassing.
I used to know. I used to be able to like. That was my only list I could ever make.
Okay.
We talk about the fact women and men.
Oh my! I see
he's
where she
a
goes
list
with
maker.
This. We
no.
talked about this before.
With him? With them? No, we talked about with list maker. You'll be like, I'll be like.
Men make
and
lists.
Be like,
it's
top
how we.
Sunny days it's... of my childhood. Let's see. Number 10 is when I went to the park to go. He can make a list of anything in the entire world. It's very cute.
Men
I. Don't list crap. Like, it doesn't dawn on me to list. I have mad, like, big groups of things. Is this a guy thing, people?
Yes, it's a guy thing.
List
guys,
making.
Back me up. We categorize. It's how we sort the world. It's how we understand things. We're like, okay, top 10 Bond films. We all do it.
Mr. Belong.
Top.
Sorry. I have ADHD. I was just reading. Yes.
Categorize Tarantino films.
Listings.
We do it. We list things.
Is listing things at top 10, is that important?
Okay, wait. Tequila or mezcal?
Mezcal.
No. Both. How could you even ask that? You have to have both. Mezcal is a dark, smoky sipping whiskey, and tequila is everything
she
else.
She only thinks it's a guy thing.
It is a guy thing. I'm telling you,
the
it is a guy
thing.
We make lists. We categorize. It is how we sort
out
the world.
I test him. This is what I do. He'll be like quietly over there reading, and I'll be like, top 10 reasons to wear orange. Oh! And he'll like almost like, he'll just start spouting out top 10 reasons to do anything. It's very cute. No kale tacos.
Can you tell me the top 10
list? Yeah, okay, now go on.
Can you tell me the top 10 list I'm thinking of right now?
How to shut your wife up?
No, I would never want to shut you up. I would never want to stop the mellifluous.
Where's the TARDIS stuff? We never had any.
What? Where's the wait? I gotta go.
Not a gender thing.
We gotta get
So women make lists too.
Where's the TARDIS stuff? I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
We've never had any.
James Joyce lived making lists. Yes, and I have got a very early edition of Ulysses.
James Joyce was not exactly normal. Great author.
Who the hell is? What great artist is normal? Show me anybody. I dare you to list here a great artist who is normal.
Top 10 normal artists.
Alright, top 10. Top 10. Yeah, okay, great, fine. Give me a top 10 normal artists. The list will be zero because there are no great artists who are normal. Francis Bacon, normal, yes or no?
No.
Pablo Picasso. James Joyce.
There are a few other artists.
Marcel Proust.
I think artists by their very nature
John
are not normal.
Freaking Coltrane.
Because they are... Artists can be normal. Normal are people that live within a very narrow construct of what reality is. And artists go beyond. Francis is back. Franny was gone for a week. And now he's back.
Top 10 dogs in this room. Francis and Scabigail.
It's a short list.
By the way, we don't understand why. We're going to cook in a minute, I swear. We just needed a break. We don't understand this, but every time we do Quarantine Kitchen, about half an hour before we start the show, Scabigail comes over and gets in this corner. It is the only time that she does this. I'm gonna make a list, top 10 times that Scabigail got in the corner.
Quarantine kitchen.
All right, I've got a griddle because we're gonna make tortillas. You don't have to use a griddle, it's just we have it, so I'm gonna use it. If you don't have one, a good cast iron pan will most certainly serve perfectly well, probably over just whatever medium high heat happens to be. Now we have leftovers, and you know the thing is I think every family that has leftovers has to have a strategy for dealing with them. List of top 10 ways that one can deal with leftovers. One.
Oh my God, I walked right into this.
So one, pizza. Two, script. Really?
She doesn't like lists.
You don't like lists?
She's like, enough with
so
the lists.
Scabs has a bad paw, and so when she sleeps on the floor, she has to...
the bad paw happened before we had her.
We rescued her from a very, very bad situation where she was had her leg broken and nobody bothered
this
to set it.
This is why you adopt. Because
and this is why you adopt
this
rescue
is
dogs.
You see this.
Yeah, this leg.
It was literally broken.
They said that it could be. We could re-break it and reset it and make it normal, but we don't want to put her through that. So, no. So,
I think it's the first time I've heard her bark.
I don't even know what the hell she's like. I'm like, God damn it, I'm sick of this shit. What are you guys doing? You gonna make some goddamn food or what? So, top 10.
Here's the list.
So, the top 10 things to do with leftovers. Make a pizza, scrambled eggs, tacos.
Omelets, I mean, it's part of it.
Omelets is basically, it's basically scrambled eggs. And I would say a casserole. Because like right now, we could take every leftover we have here, stir it up with egg and mayonnaise and breadcrumbs, stick it in a pan, fried rice, which we've done, with the kimchi. I know some of you are very, always wanting to know what's happening with the kimchi.
Visitation of the kimchi.
I know it's in here. I just don't know where.
It's buried.
There's so much shit buried in here. I mean, look at this. This is a container of tubes of things. This is like anchovy paste, harissa, tomato paste. This is medicine. This is fish sauce. So the...
People come in, like, the secret ingredient being the neck guard and heart guard.
I don't know if it's in here.
No, it's definitely in there. Unless we took it to the lake. No,
I didn't take... Top 10 reasons I wouldn't take the kimchi. All right, so, all right, great. We've got corn. Is this like, that's not Silver Queen. It's
very
the wrong
white,
shape.
Though. No, but it's really white.
Whole Foods, you could do a much better job of labeling things. This did come from Whole Foods, I know, because I...
Whole Foods. Do you guys shop? I want to know this for sure because I want to we usually shop at really small mom and pop plant stands.
We go to farm stands in this place called Nature's Pick. Here in Marietta,
which Yay, we plan Nature's Pick.
Nature's Pick, which we plan on turning into a massive national conglomerate.
Anybody watching, awesome. If you live anywhere near Marietta, Georgia, please go to Nature's Pick. They're wonderful.
Because listen, I hate Whole Foods. I'm not going to lie. I don't like Whole Foods. I don't like that whole... I used to, and then, you know, Whole Foods was great, and then they sold out 100%, all of their beliefs, all of everything, to Lord Bezos. Who's going to be, they say he's going to be our first trillionaire. Should anybody be a trillionaire?
No, he has goals, okay? Yeah. The man has goals. And I'm sorry, during the COVID. No.
During the COVID what?
I have partaken in the Amazon-ness of the world.
Look, we have all partaken in the Amazon-ness. But I've gotten to where I try to buy things from a lot of other places.
Shouldn't Amazon be responsible for keeping the real Amazon alive? Shouldn't Amazon.com
Jeff Bezos, if you're going to take the name, if you're going to take the name of the river, shouldn't you get your bald ass down?
The river?
I thought that's what you're talking about, the Amazon
River.
Yeah,
the Amazon forest.
Shouldn't you get your rich bald ass down there and what?
All our air. I mean, a lot of our air comes from the Amazon rainforest.
You should get your bald ass down to the river.
Amazon.
Take me to the...
No.
Next week.
No, we're not doing that next week.
Why not? Why can't we do...
It's too hard.
You want to hear Take Me to the River? Because
it's too difficult for me. No. Top 10 reasons not to do...
Top 10 reasons to play Take Me to the River next week.
I'm not ready. That's a hard bass line. Thank you very much. I've been playing the bass for 6 weeks, people.
Jeff Bezos.
Okay.
You're doing wonderfully, dear.
Don't throw me into that river.
Okay, we're not. Jeff Bezos needs to go to the river and save it.
Yeah.
Take me to the river.
Maybe he does. Maybe I'm wrong. People.
Take me to the
river. No. People. They know these things. They are so good. They are so quick on this stuff. Does Jeff Bezos donate to the Amazon rainforest?
Because he should.
Does he?
Jeff.
He may.
Mr. Bezos. I realize that you're in your interplanetary space pod right now, probably.
Major
Jeff.
Anyway,
you need to get your ass, your rich bald ass, down to.
Maybe. I want to give him the benefit of the doubt.
We would know.
Can you read the question? You can read answers coming in.
No, they're saying no.
No, he does
Alton,
not.
Favorite shaving products.
Top
what does
10.
That have to do with
top
it?
Top 10 shaving.
My top. Do you want me to...
You shave.
I have a regimen for shaving that involves two different clippers. Every hair above my neck is cut to the same length. It's basically a 1 millimeter cut. We have to get to cooking now because clearly things have gone.
Okay, I want to send them on missions. Does Amazon.com...
I don't think Amazon... Oh, by the way, we moved a globe to put a light up.
In case anyone's, well, I know they are. They're all like, ooh. Okay.
You know what that light reminds me of? We watched the movie Sunshine over the weekend. It was the first time that I'd seen it.
It's a good movie.
It's a good movie, but I got some issues with it. It's beautifully shot. It's got some really great acting.
If you've not seen it, Danny Boyle's Sunshine.
Yeah, but it's like one guy. They leave it up to one guy late at night to put in the entire trajectory for the spacecraft that is going to save the planet. And like, oh, he screws up something. In no movie would that actually happen.
No, I understand. No movie.
And Mark Strong's character.
Movie, it might.
Mark Strong's character would be dead.
It's still, I think,
dead.
A beautiful movie because it talks about human fallibility.
It
talks about guilt.
And I have to tell you, it's the second movie that I liked.
Slay Murphy.
No.
Chris Evans.
Okay, I don't... typically a Chris Evans fan, but Knives Out.
Yeah. No, he was very good. I like Slay Murphy.
With the fake knife?
Yeah.
Shit. He played that so well. Oh, CSI KFC. Best line in the movie. CFI KFC, best line in the movie.
I also thought he was really great. The whole scene between he and whatever... I don't know her name, but you just ate a whole pot of beans.
You just ate a whole pot of beans, and if you lie, you vomit.
You vomit, so.
Yeah, spectacular movie. Although, why they decided to put holes in a sweater, I don't know. All right, so I'm going to make...
I read that.
So, the masa.
The masa. Okay, we have had a conversation that almost turned into an argument.
Conversation. Go ahead. I'm going to make another cocktail.
That's what women use. He wants to do straight up, which is fine. So, I used to
make... There's nothing wrong with being straight.
But I made salsa, and sometimes I have in the past put my salsa, not pico. We've had this conversation before, people.
Salsa. Can't quite show because I'm afraid it's going to fall out.
Yeah, I made it. See, there you go. It's more liquidy this time. As a little bit of salsa into
what is the green?
Cilantro. And also jalapeno. I'm drinking carcass. Anyway, I think we should put.
Do you want another cocktail?
Yes, I would like.
It will make me more handsome.
No, it won't. But I love you regardless of whether or not you're more handsome or less handsome than when I start out drinking.
Look, you have a halo. So you want me to make you another one, in other words?
Yes, please.
Okay, we have to make the masa soon because we've got to make the tortillas.
I understand.
These people aren't going to put up with any too much of our shit. 35 minutes. Because you guys don't like just hanging.
Just go. Just and make the drink.
And the monkey makes the drink. I'll just be over here making the drink.
The monkey. Shock the monkey. Shock the monkey. Peter Gabriel, one of his favorite
You albums. Told me you didn't even like that album. I'm sorry, but So is probably... You're on your own. Have fun with that. Go ahead.
Here's my life. Wait, Alton, who was So produced by? And where was it recorded?
This conversation with you.
Anyway, it's not true. It's very important information. It really is.
You're being so sarcastic.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. No. I'm really not. No, there are a lot of people. There are a lot of people, very many people, that go into making pieces of art amazing. And producers and...
Wait. What the hell? Shock the Monkey wasn't even on So. I'm sorry.
What was it on?
I don't remember. It was on the one before So. Yes, there's a piece of ephemera that
Red
I don't know.
Red Rain is
That was on
down.
So.
Red
I just want a sledgehammer.
Rain. I have to sing. And people, it annoys people when I sing. But I'm not so much, I'm not close to the end.
Sledgehammer, big time. Red
I don't
Rain.
Like sledgehammer.
In your eyes. So.
So one
not,
of us,
not
this
Shock
is interesting. One of us is a baby boomer, or a boomer, him.
Oh shit, I don't remember if I put this vermouth in there.
He's the last year of boomer. I am like one of the first years of Gen X. And we find, although both in our 50s, that there is a difference in our influences. This is so weird because I can see all these comments coming in and it's
well,
like having a conversation.
Well, here's one right now. Check out Secret World with Paula Cole before anyone knew her. Great video. That's got nothing to do with anything we were talking
about.
Yeah, it does. But it's nice.
Kind of 80s.
Okay, Boomer, says Dan J. You think you're clever, do you, Dan? Do you?
Maybe really? Dan's a Boomer.
No, Dan's not a Boomer. I'm just hanging out like the swearing alcohol-laced version of you guys.
Are you new to the party?
Yeah, where
Perhaps
you been?
You're new to the party.
Where the hell have you been?
Yeah.
Because
Welcome
Quarantine Kitchen
quarantine
is pretty
kitchen.
Much at the bar with the Browns.
Here we are.
And a foul-mouthed lot we are. I am sorry.
Well, I'm from Boston, so that's my excuse. You're just crotchety. I mean, I'm even from Boston to admit, like, pretty much we came out swearing. Or like, you know, hey, world, here I fucking am. Hey, fucking world, here I fucking am. Okay, I have shredded both the chicken.
Well, somebody needs to make...
Will you please talk about how you cook this chicken? Because I'm
I
not
smoked
joking.
It. That's
I'm not
the
just
end of
saying
conversation.
This.
It, I smoked
yeah.
the chicken. I will maybe
This is the best chicken I have ever eaten in my entire life. And I'm not just saying that because this man's my
Top
husband.
Top 10 no, best chicken.
This one. this one. Top
10. Okay, guys, we're the top 10. Yeah, I can smoke a friggin' chicken. I'm really good at that. And so we've got breast meat. And,
what did you do, though? I want you to tell them what you did. Because
no, I'm not. Because maybe we'll do it. Maybe one week we'll go out and we'll smoke one.
Do you want to see us being at the lake house smoking?
It's a shack. They don't want to see us in a shack. They think we're like... No? The I don't even know shack. If we have enough internet. Our internet is dicey. Anyway, we had a fight. No. A disagreement about how to make the tortillas, but we need to get on with this. So I want you to do it your way. She swears that she can make a really tasty, am I speaking out of turn?
No, I'm thinning up.
She wants to replace, so typically when you're using this kind of masa flour to make an instant masa for tortillas, you use two cups of the powdery mix and a cup and a half of water. But she wants to replace the half cup of one half of the cup, so a third of the liquid amount with salsa, which it could be a good idea. Could also be.
All right. Full disclosure: I used to make. I had a tortilla press, but an electronic one actually. Thank you.
You're gonna need this.
I'm gonna just go to.
And I used to actually add wheat flour, but I can't do that anymore because I can't do wheat. So here I am. What?
I left the tortilla press at the office.
Okay. I still love you.
So we don't have a tortilla press, but we can come up with something. I can still roll tortillas. Don't worry.
If anyone can, it's you. It's totally fine.
Where is our, do you know where our baking perfect beaker is? Because that's the thing we need to measure the water with. Because we got
perfect beaker.
So you want a cup of water? Look, I have a halo. Look, I have a halo. Top 10 movies with halos. Top 10 Renaissance games with halos.
Okay, wait. So your recipe is 1.5 cups?
Well, that's what she's want on the bag. That's fine. I mean, it's not my recipe. It's their recipe.
Oh.
It's 2 cups of this, scoop and sweep.
2 cups of this?
2 full cups.
Okay.
And then 1.5 cups of water.
Okay.
There so you're going to replace half of that with salsa.
Not half. I said a third.
Okay. Well, it'll be a lot easier to do the math if you just do 1/4 cup of that and 1 1/4 cup of this.
I'm fine with that. Mm-hmm. How are you doing the elote?
There. I'm going to cook the elote right on the cooktop.
Do you want to show them what I'm like pouring and stuff?
Is oh, hold on.
How do we do it?
So.
Uh-oh.
Here. Nobody wants to see me anyway. Here, hold on.
They all want to see you.
Somebody said sit on 2 cutting boards with masa flour dough between them. Thanks, Taylor. Go. That's incredibly helpful. So that's what I need is another person telling me I'm fat. Thanks for that.
Okay, this is looking very dry, very, very, very dry.
It's looking, you haven't put in your salsa yet.
I understand, I'm just saying. Very, 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 very dry. So I have been getting requests somehow, because I don't.
Shall I?
Sure.
You've been getting requests for what?
One cocktail. Gluten-free and healthy thing. But I think we're all, you know, food is medicine. Sorry to not sound like Gwenny, but...
Gwenny!
No, Gwenny's done okay, two things. Gwenny's brave.
Gwenny's brave?
She is brave. She's other things
she sells. She has a website that sells vagina rocks. What's so brave about
that? That's brave. That's pretty.
It's not brave to sell them. It's brave to use them.
Does anyone use one of those?
No. Top 10 reasons why on Quarantine Kitchen we're not going to talk about Yanni stones. About why we're not going to discuss Yanni stones. In fact, I'm going to now go in and to the pantry and get some things that that I need. This has gone really off the rails. You know, we're already 45 minutes in and we haven't made any food yet. You guys don't want to hang out with us that long. I know. So for the elote, of course, Mexican street corn. We're gonna need some chili powder. So I've got some chili powder here. See, we're gonna need a cheese thing. know what? We can use, we can actually use Parmesan. We can grate Parmesan. So I'm gonna get rid of this pan. How's your dough coming together? See, now that looks a little that looks a little wet to me.
Okay, I can put a little more.
Yeah, that's not gonna make a,
I understand.
A tortilla. Right.
I got it.
All right, you get it. Okay, so I'm gonna cook that corn right here. Once I find it, Scabs, you all right? Scabigail, you good? Franny, hey, you're such a good boy. Okay. Hey, you know, we do have some queso fresco. We've got queso fresco. So we can, I'm going to use that and the, excuse me.
How's your arm, baby?
My arm hurts. It's full of holes. It feels like Frankenstein's face. Where the hell? Jeez. Where's the, oh crap, it's already out. No, that's still too wet. Okay. We're gonna end up with a lot of masa. Yeah, that's still too wet.
I think so too. I agree.
Just keep dosing that stuff in there. Okay, so here's the way I'm gonna play this. I'm going to crank up an eye here, and I'm not gonna do anything to that. I'm just gonna plop that on the bun. I mean, typically I would. You want that cocktail? I'm sure you do. Wait. Gwyneth Paltrow is a con artist selling fake medicine. She should be brought up on charges.
I'm not saying she's an idol. I'm just saying she has been brave enough to talk about alternative forms of medicine.
I wonder if I should have cut those. You know what? I think I should have.
Woo! You're making popcorn over there.
All corn pops. Everybody, all right, hold on. I have to go in for a knife. You know, we don't have one big enough, really, to... I'm going to use...
You want a machete?
I need a machete. Hold on. All right, I guess that'll do. Franny, watch out, buddy. I'm going to try to cut this in half with one hand. I don't know that
here. I can
here,
do
can
this.
You hold the camera
I can actually...
while
I am a professional now. Oops. Da-da-da-da. Oh! Seriously, if you were to put that on like that, does corn have to be dried to actually pop to make popcorn?
Yeah. It actually has to be popcorn. I can't cut through this cob.
Saber.
Really?
All corn pops at 350?
Well, it does.
Snap corn in half. No, I'm not a professional. I understand that. I'm just kidding.
You are a professional.
No, someone
else. Well, really? Screw them. Hey, whoever told her she wasn't a professional... Fuck off and go home. It's our show. So, are you at a... How is that? Can you make it into some balls?
I can make it into some balls.
And we've got our chicken and we've got...
Ball up.
I'm going to need some mayonnaise. I'm going to need some limes. I hope we got
you're
all this stuff.
Out in the universe, like
I am. I'm speaking out to the. I am going to need. Someone please send to me immediately. I don't even know.
I'm ball making.
Mayonnaise. Dukes, because we don't screw around.
Why Dukes? Let's talk about
Dukes. Because Dukes is freaking amazing.
Where's Dukes made?
Dukes is. Is Dukes made? Yeah. It's made in one of the Carolinas. Holy crap. Well, it's made by Sour Brands. So that's out of Richmond, Virginia. I want to say, is it North Carolina or South Carolina? It's one of the Carolinas, right? But the thing about Duke's is that it is, it's made with apple cider vinegar. So it's...
Oh, that's a health product.
Crap. Wow. I'm losing control of my stuff.
Is your corn going rogue corn. I'm impressed.
Get... back over here. I want it pretty charred, but I don't want it that charred. Half chop the corn and then use the heel of the other hand to hit the back of the blade. Hey, Jason.
You got this.
What do you think I freaking did? And by the way, The only chef's knife I have here is relatively small because all the good ones at work. So if you think you want to teach me cooking, you know where I am. Come on down, but bring your mom and your girlfriend if you've got one, because I want to embarrass you in front of them.
He's being helpful. He's concerned. He knows you're injured.
I know what that means. He's being helpful. Not being helpful. I know exactly what you're talking about. Yeah, I do know what that means. Yeah.
I'm just hoping. You mean you're telling me exactly how it has to be?
Telling you how it has to be.
Thank you.
Telling you how it's going.
Yeah.
Telling you how it's going to be. Mm-hmm. Put your heel on the. Put your hand up.
Mansplaining?
You know, there's also such a thing as woman-splaining.
No, we just shame.
No.
Women's shaming.
Women-splaining is when you talk about something, and then once whatever man you live with says that he understands and that you're right, you want to talk about it for four more goddamn hours.
Just to make sure all the bases are covered. I want to make sure all the points are.
Does it sound about right? About four more hours?
Yeah.
I love you.
You just kissed me off camera.
I did kiss you off camera. Well, do you want me to kiss you on camera? Look, that's not a problem.
I'm just saying.
You want me to stick my tongue in your ear on camera? Because there's a name for that. All right, I think you need to start. Okay, so she's made masa balls. We can mash those in this plastic bag because we're going to need to get those onto the griddle.
Okay.
Right?
Mash it.
And I'm cooking my corn.
And so we're going to mash them with
your hand on the back of the knife. I had to go down.
We're going to mash them with, he learned from you. He's just showing that he learned from you.
No, he didn't learn from me. He's going to learn from me.
All right, so we're going to,
Could I use a grill for this, by the way? Yes, I absolutely could use a grill, but I thought it was going to rain. I still kind of think that it's going to rain.
So I didn't want to deal with it.
This
is going to be the grilling episode.
We will do a grilling episode. We absolutely will do a grilling episode. I'm just going to let that go. All right, so we've got mayonnaise, which I'm going to try to open under my arm.
I'll do it.
No, I got it. Oh, crap. There's nothing like when a one-armed person has to encounter one of these. Oh, I can't even deal with that before I have a more cocktail.
What would you like to
know? Oh. Wait. To all you long list, 4 hours is needed to talk to you to prioritize. What the hell? Okay, I'm just going to ignore. We got some haters tonight, sweetheart. We got some haters. We got some people being real assholes. You know, you don't have to watch.
Yeah, you can move on. Move on to some other program. Okay. You want me to do what? Put the balls in the bag and mash them with what? A wine bottle?
I want you to put those balls in a bag. And
then we. Not the balls.
You know what? You just figure it out. No, I'm not mansplaining shit to you. No, absolutely. You're right. You're right.
Nope.
You don't need me. You do not need me to mansplain nothing. Go on. It's fine. You just figure it out. Tortillas.
I was not accusing you. I'm just asking. You had told me. Because I'm just using a press.
Well, we don't have a press because your husband left it at the office. So she's put the masa dough, which we have here in ball form. Because, you know, balls are where most culinary things begin.
See, it's stuck. Mm. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's too moist.
So maybe we just put it on the griddle and smash them.
Yeah.
Or we'll play like they're arepa, kind of, almost.
Yeah.
All right, well, come cook those bad boys. Then. There we go.
Arepa!
Almost an arepa, not actually an arepa, but, you know, kind of close. So I need to get, ow, that shit's jumping.
This is where, okay, is the griddle ready?
Wait, can you add cider vinegar to regular mayonnaise? You can add cider vinegar to regular mayonnaise, but odds are if the mayonnaise is already made, it's going to throw off the consistency a little bit. But here's the thing. You can, from places like Spice House up in Evansville, Illinois, you can buy vinegar powder. If you get yourself a little vinegar powder, hell yes.
I didn't know that.
You can get vinegar powder and you can add it to things like that, and you won't have to worry about the liquid part, so that you can make vinegar better. And if you live in a place where you can't get Duke's vinegar, and I do feel kind of sorry for you, sorry, Duke's mayonnaise, then you can add a little apple cider vinegar powder to whatever mayonnaise you use, as long as it's not like Hellman's, which is...
Hellman's. I grew up on Hellman's.
Well, that's Yankee shit. There we go. I don't like Hellman's. And Miracle Whip is salad dressing, as far as I'm concerned. Scabs, back me up on this.
Jerkies.
Scabs? Scabs?
What about jerkies?
All right. I don't even know what that means. So, we've got mayonnaise because we're going to have to spread that on... things are going out of control here. This is the worst quarantine kitchen yet, because all right, what are the top 10? Out of the 13 episodes of Quarantine Kitchen, what are the 10 worst? Shit. Somebody's gonna come up with that too. All right, I need a brush. No, I don't. I'll use a spatula. So we're gonna use a spatula to put the mayonnaise on the elote. We also have our, here. I only have one handle. You pull that open.
Teamwork. That's fucking
teamwork.
Teamwork.
Anybody
know Tenacious D?
Everybody knows Tenacious
D. That's
fucking
teamwork. Teamwork.
Yeah. All right. I need this rasp. And an alarm.
I love this corn over here just like hopping away.
Oh, shit. That's a lemon. What the hell? All right. Hey, one arm.
I can help you, but...
Did you want to throw some of this asparagus on there, or...
Oh, yeah.
Well, here. So here's a pro tip.
Okay.
I save leftover Chinese takeout containers to hold things like leftover... Nobody's watching anymore, by the way. They all logged out. They're all gone. It's just us now, baby.
Good.
I can't do this with one hand. Ugh, I can't. I'm one-handed.
I understand.
Well, okay, there's our... That looks kind of old, but we're going to use it anyway. All right. Scabs, you good? All right. I don't know where Franny went. So, the elote action, I like it really done, personally. I like to see a fair amount of dark. I've certainly got it. Got it there. Ooh, that one's...
Yeah, that's burnt. Do we
do the cheese? Oh, no. Crap.
I'll do that.
We're going to need a grater for that. Oh, yeah. Do you want to use the Parmesan or the Fresco? All right, well, here. I don't think that's going to work. Yeah, it's not going to work.
No,
is this yours or mine?
That's mine.
That's yours?
Don't touch it. You can't touch this.
I cannot tell you how many Wednesdays I now have a hangover from this show.
Where's the Fresco?
I'm doing that for you guys. The Fresco's already out, baby.
Take it one for the team.
Fresco.
One for the team.
The nice thing about Fresco, it's kind of like feta, but it's not as salty and it's not as hard, but it lasts as long in the refrigerator, which is really, really good. So we try to always keep this stuff around. We bought this before... the quarantine shit hit the fan. And it says sell by 8/29/20. So that tells you something about how long that'll last. Oh, thank you for suffering Wednesday hangovers for us.
So the word fresco is actually a misnomer.
Tell us. Tell it. Explain.
Well, fresco means
can I flip
fresh.
These? Or did you already do that?
You can flip.
Okay, because these are done. So. Fresco means fresh. Go ahead.
August, it's not really fresh, is it?
You know,
I love it. It's my favorite cheese. I love queso fresco, by the way. Adore.
Okay. I'm going to remove the corn. Oh, crap. We have this perfectly good motion picture light.
Leftover from your morning shoot. Thank you.
There we go. There we go. Now we can drag that up here and have some actual light. I just forgot to do that. It looks like we just turned car lights on. It's pretty ugly, but I don't have time to fix it right now.
That works. spare equipment laying around really is nice.
Well, we're shooting here so much now.
Yeah.
Because...
Are people still quarantining?
Are people still quarantining? We'd like to know. How many of you guys really are still
quarantining? Know.
Always sell the coffee. That's true. Anybody?
I mean,
anybody still quarantining?
Yeah. I don't mean literally, well, okay, like we were initially, but...
Anybody?
Restaurants, no restaurants?
Yes, and people say yes, 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 mostly. New York City, hell yes.
Yeah.
Wait, upstate New York, we're good. The masks and distancing. Glad to see we have sheep ham. Da, da, da. Yes, yes. Still quarantining in Texas. Yes,
really?
We are.
Texas.
Florida, quarantine. You know, look, here's the thing. It's math.
So we have
math.
A learned, knowledgeable, scientifically based watching audience.
We do. Our people make sense. All right, I have to get these off the heat.
Get them off the heat.
Because we've got to make dinner because it's freaking 8 o'clock.
Here.
Hold on, let me flip this over because nobody wants to look at me.
Arepa!
Do you want me to cook some more?
Arepa!
I mean, it's not technically an arepa, but we're going to call it that just because.
Yes, so these are not really yours. You're right.
It's...
Okay. We'll taste them anyway.
She doesn't even care. You can cook some more if you want. Okay, I've got to get to the elote, so I got to get my cocktail.
Yeah.
I'm tired of dragging around this camera, quite frankly. DC, yes. Indiana, no.
No.
Somebody said they are not doing that in Indiana, and that's okay. Look, you don't have to quarantine. We're just curious.
No, this is
so
all
I'm going to rub down.
Sweden didn't. And
yeah, Sweden, aren't they all dead?
Look, you know what? In X many years, however many, 8,
well, I'll
10,
be dead.
20, 40 years, we're going to be able to look back and go, that was the right plan. But
mayonnaise now going on the elote. Well, maybe we won't. Maybe we won't know because maybe it's different for everybody. I don't know. Mayonnaise. There's no substitute. Don't even think you can make elote without mayonnaise because you can't. I'm going to set it up on end. Duke's mayonnaise. There we go.
Tasty.
What's that?
These little repa things are pretty tasty.
Well, don't eat them all. I haven't had one yet.
I'm not. I'm just saying. So we did argue because I knew.
We did argue. They can't quite see you. Look up. There she is. I keep trying to find shots. It's tough. It's like a documentary,
it's
but
tough.
My arm hurts. I need more painkiller.
That's what you should name this drink, the painkiller.
Well, there is a drink called a painkiller, though.
What's in it?
Shit, I don't remember. What's in a painkiller, guys? I don't remember. And then there's also penicillin. That's a scotch drink, though. So this one that's burned, I'm going to put a lot of mayonnaise on because I burned it. I'm going to eat the burned one, though. Don't you worry. And then we're going to sprinkle all this down in.
See, now the singing begins.
Now the singing begins?
Don't you worry about the
mayonnaise. Do you love mayonnaise? Do you want to lick my fingers?
Oh, my gosh. Not on camera.
You do it off camera. Mm-hmm. You do it over here?
I'm cooking asparagus.
Fine. The asparagus is already cooked.
Well, I'm heating it up.
All right. Well, I'm going to put some chili powder. This
right,
is...
Do you want to heat the chicken at all, or is it beautiful?
You know, throw the. You know, that's a really good question. Throw the chicken on the griddle. Is there a room?
Yeah.
Oh crap.
Well, there will be. No, it's not. Actually.
All right. Well. So I'm gonna lay the.
Here, I'm gonna do it though.
I'm gonna lay down, laying it down. So, I may have gone a little overboard with the chili powder. But I'm a one-armed person, so I'm having a bit of a problem. What? I'm a one-armed person right now. Oh, crap. Do we want, which cheese do we want on here? Because we have to have cheese now. What?
The Fresco. It's right here.
All right, where is it? I need a big chunk of this Fresco. I need like that much. Actually, the aged version of this would be better for this.
Which is what? The heater?
Yeah. I don't know that that's going to work. I may have to also use some Parmesan.
Oh, yeah. You want to use Parmesan all day.
Well, I have wanted to use Parmesan all day because I don't think that's going to do it. Because look, it's not crumbly enough. This is very young cheese.
Young cheese.
Well, you make this stuff with one hand. I'm telling you, it's not as easy as it looks. Oh, my God. So this is starting to look like Kentucky Fried Movie Heritage Loaf. This is bad. This is real. Oh, shit.
Okay, chicken going on the grill.
Chicken going down.
Okay.
Fine, I'll work my own fingers.
Okay, pretty good. Very good. Gotta admit.
I think we need some Parmesan. But I can't grate Parmesan with one hand. Do you realize? They were like an hour five. This is going to be the longest quarantine kitchen ever.
What are you talking about? We have done like almost 2 hours.
We have not?
Yes, we have.
No. We have not done almost 2 hours.
Yes,
back me up.
No.
Make a list ranking the length of all the quarantine kitchen shows.
We've done hour 40. Yes, we have.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
We've never gone that long.
Oh, my God.
Can I try one of these?
We had hour 50 one night. I guarantee you.
Shit, that's good. Holy crap, that's really, really good. All right, then I want the Parmesan. I know that I've got a block of Parmesan in here.
Why do you want the Parmesan? Let's talk about that. Why?
I don't know. I just do.
You know why? Because you want to make a point about something. What's that?
I don't know that the seasoning is Parmesan, but I'm going to use it anyway. We've lost all but our most faithful viewers anyway at this point. Nobody cares anymore. They've all gone off to watch other things. Because everything's open now. They've all gone out to bars and bowling alleys and moving theaters. Nobody wants to stay home with us. That's fine. We don't care.
We're still here in quarantine.
We're still here. We're going to be in Quarantine Kitchen forever. When you guys are all back, we will still be here quarantining for you, America. I don't even know what kind of cheese this frickin' is. I think it's pecorino.
Why have you been so hell-bent on using Parmesan, though?
Because I just think that it's a mashup that needs to happen. This is so hideous.
What's hideous?
Shit. I'm supposed to be able to cook.
And normally, yeah.
And normally? I'm a good cook.
Oh my God.
Just not tonight.
The things you do with meat are like...
The things I do with meat.
Yeah.
The things I do with meat. The things I do with meat. Like walking in the rain and the snow. Wait, I don't know the rest of the words. I am good with meat.
Yes.
They asked me once, would you ever compete on Iron Chef America? And I was like, yeah, if it's meat. The only other way that I told them that I would compete on Iron Chef America is if I got to challenge Iron Chef Masaharu Morimoto and that there would be no fish allowed anywhere in the kitchen. Like, it would be like battle beanie weenie. Can you guys just see Mark Dacascos going, beanie weenie?
Beanie weenie?
Because I would kick his ass. I would kick Morimoto's ass with beanie weenies. You take away that man's fish? He's got nothing. He's got nothing. I'm telling you.
All right. Where is he now?
I don't know where Morimoto is now. I don't know. Morimoto land. Hawaii. I know he has a lot of things going down in Hawaii. So now I'm putting some lime zest on
Hawaii.
The elote. What?
Hawaii?
Hawaii. It's like Japan light.
I love Hawaii.
I like Hawaii too.
Waikiki.
This is the ugliest dish of food I've ever made in my life. Holy shit, that's ugly.
I don't think it'll look well. It'll be very pretty. Did you make elote, baby?
Sweetheart, come over and look.
Oh,
my god.
But it smells good. I'll eat it anyway. Okay. It's leftover Tuesday here. Leftover Tuesday, folks. That's what you get.
Leftover Tuesdays. All right, what we got? So you cooked some. What's happening with the leftover asparagus?
I don't know.
So what you cooked? You recooked the chicken. All right, we need to. These are like these aren't kitchen.
I don't know. You put them right
out. Is this your cocktail over here?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, stop drinking my cocktail.
I didn't drink your cocktail. You hush your mouth.
Because they will tell me.
No, they won't. Yes, of course they will tell you if I lie to you. I wouldn't lie to you.
Mm-hmm. I'm not
going to
sing, would I lie to you?
Would I lie to you, honey? Would I something, something that wasn't true? Could I
tell you something? Forever.
Annie Lennox next week.
Yeah, oh, they're doing it now.
All right. All right, hold on. So you're putting down some of these things. Those didn't look anything like tortillas, but that's fine. This light is very disturbing. Hold on. Yeah, we'll try to turn this.
Arepa.
Oh shit!
Really good, and it's gluten free.
Hey, can you come over and tighten the knuckle on this light stand because I don't have another hand. Yeah, right there. Tighten up. Great. Thanks. I'll have to angle this down a little bit. There we go. All right.
Queso.
So I'm gonna let you choose your own beautiful elote.
Jesus.
Don't. Don't you judge me. I was doing the best I could with what I had.
I'm serving you this one, which is encrusted in chili. Wow, what happened?
I had
a party going on.
I've got a condition. I'm like Marvin in Sin City. I got a condition, and
you're right. You are working.
Top 10 dishes to eat over the sink. Hey,
wow.
You know there's a really good movie. Name a movie that's about making lists.
Say Anything.
Oddly enough, I would disagree with you, Don. Jump. What?
High Fidelity.
High Fidelity is a movie about making lists.
Yeah.
All right, so this is ugly, but delicious.
Uh-huh. All right, come over here.
I can't come over there. I have to eat over the sink.
I can't booze eat over the sink. All right. You drank all my... All right, that's fine.
I did not. What are you talking about? You've been slopping that stuff down like a mad woman all night.
Okay. All right, can you show... All right, so look, we did this.
I don't even know where to frickin' put this. Hold on. What about... What about the asparagus that's burning away?
I'm bringing it over. Do something professional.
Oh, they're pointing out the 10 things I hate about you.
That's another
one. Is another movie about Liz.
Is that also? No, it's not. We're doing that.
Yeah. I never saw 10 things I hate about you. Because I figured there was a movie that one of my ex-wives made about me.
Wow. You're just full of class tonight.
Full of class?
Okay.
I don't have to be full of class. You bring the class, baby. I bring the...
Okay. Here's Janice's tray. You feeling good?
So, this is this great tray that our friend Janice, who lives in the same loft as us, gave us. It's fabulous. We love it.
Okay. Look, we're going to do this.
All right. This is what we're going to do.
So, these are arepa. This is the elote that he made, which is really freaking tasty. I already tasted it. These are like little arepas. They were going to be tortillas, but they're not. They're arepas. Explain to them what arepa is. Let me get spoons.
No, well, let's do that in another show because you might actually make arepas.
Well,
it's
okay,
like a little corn-based. It's like a corn-based sandwich, actually.
Well, they're arepa-like.
So, I don't want the fish. I want the chicken. So I'm taking some of the chicken and I'm going to put on my arepa-like device. I'm going to put a little bit. The cheese, the queso. Can I use this spoon?
Yeah.
So, a little bit of salsa.
And the salsa is the mashed up. Oh, see, I gave you this one, and this is what.
We'll put that over here.
This is mine. Okay, I'm gonna eat this.
Hmm.
It's stinking delicious. And you know what's really delicious is your salsa. What did you put in this? Because it's fantastic, sweetheart. You make very good salsa.
What do you
think?
I mean...
When we eat, sometimes it's not pretty. We usually do this naked.
Sometimes, maybe. No. Not usually. Not usually. Wow.
Wow.
Next week he will not be. He's actually not on painkillers.
I'm not on painkillers, but I should be.
No. Wow. Maybe they should have provided you with some and then we wouldn't. Okay.
It's okay. I would rather drink than have painkillers.
Yeah.
This is fantastic. So this is a great couple exercise, as you've seen.
So initially you were like, I don't want to put salsa in the tortillas. Admittedly.
I was skeptical. I was skeptical.
Well, what about tortillas? You're not familiar with that.
I thought we were going to make straight up tortillas.
Yeah.
You were right.
Yeah. I weren't right.
So this is my elote. We've gone an hour and 15 minutes, but we're willing to hang here a little longer. Oh, look, our viewership has dropped from 5,000 to 4.9. YouTube tells you things like that.
Questions.
Oh, what's in the salsa? What's in the salsa?
Roman tomato. I have to do the recipe. We're gonna, five or so Roman tomatoes, literally, of cilantro, like what you would buy in the store, a bunch. 3/4 of a white onion. I do use white for this.
She taught me to appreciate white onions again. I'd been a yellow onion guy for years.
In this. Yellow, for some reason, doesn't. One whole jalapeno. I left the seeds in this one because it wasn't super seedy. And a tiny, 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 maybe a half a teaspoon of balsamic vinegar in this one.
Really?
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of balancing sweetness. Well, I think it's delicious.
Yeah.
All right. What makes vermouth red? Well, there are a lot of different ways to make vermouth, and one of them is to actually use. I'm going to turn off the griddle. Are we done?
Thank you. Yeah, we're done.
No, we're going to. We'll griddle the rest of this one after these guys are gone. There are a lot of different ways to make vermouth with different colored grapes and by leaving certain amounts of skins on. Remember that vermouth is a fortified wine, so you can literally make. A vermouth out of any kind of wine. So there are, a rep is burps. You can have red and white, although the reds are typically, there are a few dry red vermouths, but most of the red ones are actually sweet. You against Elizabeth on Iron Chef.
Oh.
Is that what you want?
Maybe. No, he would kill me. Got my way through all of this stuff.
You do not.
I do.
You don't forest your gum through anything. Wait. Would you make a quarantine cookbook? You guys should do a quarantine cookbook.
Well, considering I think we're probably going to go back into lockdown next fall, that's just my opinion. We'll be doing this again. Well, I don't know if we're going to stop.
We'll be on tour next year.
Oh.
I hope you guys, we're going to go on tour next year, the new tour show, Beyond the Eats.
I'm playing.
It's my farewell tour.
Bass. On tour.
Elizabeth will be on stage playing bass.
Frenny's Gabigail and the.
They're living on the bus with us. Come to Miami. I hope that we will. Oh, what? Wait. Something about a watch. Cook your watch. I'm wearing a Timex, by the way. I have 3 of these in different colors. Big Timex fan. What's your favorite musical?
You're asking the wrong person.
I'm gonna have to think about that.
I love Hair.
She does. She sings from Hair. You like the Fellatio song?
Sodomy, Fellatio. That's because my mother and my father
were very liberal, and they would listen to the, my mom and I are watching, and I thank you for this.
Your mom probably is watching.
I know she's watching.
All right.
The Hair musical, and I learned every word. They probably didn't think I was listening, and then I got in trouble when I would go to school and sing Sodomy, Fellatio, at recess.
You may have got in trouble, but you were popular.
I do. I love that.
All right. I do have a favorite musical. It is not the best musical of all time.
The Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Second favorite.
Give it up.
Meatloaf again. My favorite musical because it was a turning point in my life. It was made into a movie.
And not Hamilton. Which we all love.
No, but it is political. 1776, the musical 1776, came along at a very important point in my life. I was a theater major, so I've done some musical theater. And then I got to give it up for Sweeney Todd, Stephen Sondheim.
Oh, I mean,
if I wanted to play, I wanted to play Sweeney Todd so bad. Maybe I'll get to you before it's all over. Oh, look who's up. Hey, Scabs, what the hell? You ready for, come on, you gotta get it. All right, there you go. Francis, all right. So I know we're coming down to the end of the, here, you got a bigger piece because you're a bigger dog. Go for it, there you go.
Oh my gosh, we just lost like 10 viewers because we've had people be like,
you don't let dogs eat out of your hand. Dogs are in the kitchen. Yeah, get over it.
No, like dogs in the kitchen, I can't ever watch you
yeah,
again.
Yeah, we have dogs everywhere. Well, we don't, because we only have two dogs, but we'd have more. I will go on the record as saying I like dogs better than I like people. This is actually, for as disgusting as it looks, it's not bad. So that's my favorite musical. Although, Guys and Dolls is pretty
good. Okay, any other questions? What?
Camelot. Best work type. I don't even know what that means. What edition of Joy... Blah, 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 blah. What edition of Joy of Cooking do you recommend? The 1960... It's either 62 or 63 because it was the last year that they had detailed sketches of how to skin a squirrel. And you need that.
Okay. I'm soft, you do. Yeah.
The Lego Saturn V. Look, my Lego Saturn V is still unassembled. You want to know why? Because my quarantine did not give me downtime.
Yeah, we didn't.
My quarantine gave me more work than I've ever had. So that freaking Lego Saturn V is still sitting over there in the box.
We had great hope in the first week. We're going to do all these puzzles, and it didn't happen. Ooh,
I have no idea. I want to say right now, any favorite Vincent Price movies ever read as cookbooks? Not only have I read Vincent Price's cookbooks, I have first editions of them. Vincent Price was an amazing culinarian. And the cool thing about him and his wife were that they traveled extensively. I had a huge cultural appreciation for food, and they gathered gobs and gobs of recipes. And they're really, really, really amazing books. So I'm going to have to say my favorite Vincent Price movie. It's either going to be, was it The House on Haunted Hill or The House That Dripped Blood? House That Dripped Blood and Mask of the Red Death are going to be my favorites because they're pretty awesome. Oh, somebody's telling us their favorite musical is The Wiz.
He's on down the road. He's on down.
And I can't go any further than that. Have I ever skinned a squirrel? I have. It wasn't fun, and it didn't taste good, and I don't want to do it again. It's a long time ago. We don't have to talk about it. I have skinned a squirrel.
Okay.
So we have a... Obviously, now that the food is cooked, we have...
an audience.
Watch this. I want to see what happens. Guys, fight to the death. Scabs, what the hell? You're like, yeah, I'm not going to even try. Right here, because we don't feed our dogs.
It's
obviously,
Franny's world, and she's just living in it.
All right, since it is now 8:25 almost. Oh wait, what knives are your max strip rotation right now? Well, we can't see. You want to see my knife rotation? There it is, because my lovely wife and her floral ambitions cover my knives from every angle. I can't actually get to my knives. But here, I'll point out...
flowers, not blades.
Oh, we have to get up under. What do you mean flowers, not blades? That's lame.
What?
Here, you know, I keep pocket knives up on the knife strip, and this is a Lyule that I've had for over 20 years. All the real ones have a cross shape in rivets because you're supposed to be able to plant it in the ground out in the field and have a church service. So, hey, I'll cut you. Where's your lunch money? You give me your damn lunch money, I'll cut you. I cut you so bad you wish you would never cut.
Sure.
Okay, yeah, stop that it. Didn't. Scabs knows.
She's had a hard life already.
I'm not going to cut
she doesn't
her.
She need her dad praying now.
But Francis is like, you going to cut me? I'll drop my Glock on you. It's cool, guys. Be cool. Back off. We're all cool. We're good. We're good. Somebody wants to know if I've ever choked my chicken.
Okay, that's a different show.
I don't know. I'm sure it's a show, but it's on cable. That's for sure.
Okay. All right. Well.
On that note.
Let's hope that this week improves.
Wait. What is that? Wait. Here's an altitude. What is the highest altitude you've ever cooked at? I cooked on Pike's Peak. I'm feasting on asphalt, and it wasn't easy. The higher you go, the lower the boiling point of water goes, and it's very, very difficult to get anything done. Love you, too. Thank you. We love you, too. Do you like Julia Child's cooking style?
What?
Yeah, I love it. Oh, I've cut the dickens out of myself. I liked it when she dropped stuff. What was so great about Julia Child is she made Americans not afraid of French cuisine. It was kind of like, it's okay. Drop things on the floor, chop things wrong. It doesn't matter. It's all about the joie de vivre. And I love that about her. But there are other greats in that pantheon. I mean, Jacques Pepin, certainly. The Galloping Gourmet, Graham Kerr, those original Galloping Gourmet books were great. And although he had some issues later in his career, I have to tell you, the Frugal Gourmet was my first cookbook that I bought.
Really?
Yeah. Frugal Gourmet. It was my first cookbook.
I inherited all my first cookbooks, so I don't.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that.
Viola. The Viola cookbook. I showed you that.
Yes. So many great family cookbooks. I swear she was drunk through every episode.
Me?
Oh, no, they're talking about Julia.
Oh, yeah, she might have been.
I don't know. I think that Julia could take a lot of liquor. I never met her.
I stood behind her in line in an airport in Boston once, and she was a large woman.
Is it true that her head was immense? I heard
yes,
that
her head was
immense, absolutely
and
immense.
She was like 6 feet tall. If you know, I mean, she was a yeah.
Like, Miss Child, do you want the chicken salad or the beef short rib Reuben? Because you know airlines just put words together because they think we like them. Oh, darling, I don't think I'll have anything. Bring me a bottle of vodka and a fucking vermouth. She probably didn't say it that way. No.
She might have. Yeah. All right. Let's hope that we all have a better week. A good week. And let's hope. Yeah. Let's just hope for better things. And that things get better in general.
Meanwhile, stay at home and cook with your loved ones.
Still wear your mask, people.
Cook with your loved ones.
We haven't talked about it.
Wear your masks.
Please still wear your masks. This isn't over.
We're pro-mask. Cook with your loved ones. Feed your loved ones. And we'll see you next week. Thanks for hanging with us. It's been a fabulous hour and a half.
Yeah.
Sorry. I keep looking at my watch. Yeah. I want that Timex sponsorship, so I keep doing that. See you guys next week.
Okay.
Which button is it?
The X.